Hidai, here in Fire Safety Science and Technology. He is participated in several research studies, both experimental and computational. So he's a little bit of a Renaissance knight, where he does mainly computational, but he's also able to do experiments or help in the experiments. This project has been funded mainly by the Spanish government, but also with several agreements with industrial companies. And he is the author of several international Congress papers and several international journal papers. So without further ado, I pass the word to my co-chair.
I would like to inform the speakers that the time for presentation was 15 minutes. I'm extend the time of 5 minutes to just we have three colors. The green color is all is okay. The yellow color indicates that only 2 minutes are rest of the final of the paper. Red color is the stop of the
Thank you, Chairman. I'm going to present a paper about the pyrolysis modeling of polymers. One of the most important justifications of this work and the works in this topic is the interest in modeling tools for for large scale fires. This is because the fire protection requirements are based on large scale tests. And the cost of these tests are extremely high, and it's difficult to generalize the results of the test. The modeling is a cost-efficient tool to complement the limit test data. This study is focusing the pyrolysis model of FTS, of one specific model, but and this pyrolysis model is represent one of the major boldness in the pyrolysis model in the models. The models, the predictive capacity of the models of the computational type models are limited by several parameters. All the submodels of the fire computer models, mainly the numerical quality of the differential equation solver, the quality of the spatial and temporal discretization. And the fidelity of the submodels used to represent the unresolvable physical phenomena. I have told that we are focused on the pyrolysis model in this case. In the fire designs, there are several approaches for the pyrolysis models, and originate from different approaches since empirical formulations based on experimental data obtained in CON or fluid-to-fluid calorimeter tests. Semi-empirical models consider transient heat conduction and infinitely fast pyrolysis chemistry, and compressive models based on advanced description of the in-solid heat and mass transfer process combined with finite rate pyrolysis chemistry. The compressive pyrolysis models adopt a material science perspective and describe the heat-driven chemical transformation of the virgin solid into a solid, fuel, liquid, and gaseous products. The compressive model that is used in this study has the ability to capture the influence of the gas to solid thermal loading on the rate of production of flammable vapors, for example, the fuel mass loss rate. And this model has the condition that includes a large number of unknowns coefficients. This number of unknowns can be divided in two groups, the material property group, in which we can include the density of the materials, the specific heat, the conductivity, the emissivity, etc. And the parameters of the chemical reaction, in which we can include the preferential factor of the Arrhenius equation, we can include the activation energy, we can include the heat of reaction, and other parameters of this chemical reaction. We need a calibration phase to calibrate to obtain the most of this property of this node, And in this calibration phase, we use typically the data of concalorimeter test and thermogravimetric analysis. When we use this data, this test data, in order to calibrate the model using optimization techniques. For example, we can use genetic algorithms. And with this optimization technique, we had a function to calculate the mean error between the simulation results and the experimental data. In this presentation, we are going to present the results of the methodology for a polymer flame retan component, a polymer flame retan material, in which we had developed a concalorimeter test for several heat fluxes and thermogravimetric analysis. The study considered one of the pyrolysis models incorporated to the fire dynamic simulation version 5. And this is a global one, a two-step finite rate chemistry model proposed to charge material. It's a two-state finite rate chemistry because in this material we have two reactions. And the main equation uses for this approach are the energy equation accounts for heat conduction and endothermic pyrolysis process, the mass reaction rate equation, the fuel mass loss rate equation, and the heat flux at the exposure surface of the solid material, including a radiation and a convection terms. The unknowns in this case are 17 because we had two reactions. And in this unknowns, we include the material properties, mass density, thermal conductivity, and specific heat for the react, the active, and the charged material. And we include four parameters of the radiation rate parameters, including the Kito reaction, the reaction order, and the exponential factor, and the activation energy. As I told, we use evolutionary algorithm, genetic algorithm, and these kinds of approach, these kinds of algorithms had four phases, four typical phases. The first phase is the initialization process. In this process, we calculate the initial genome, the initial individuals of the first generation, and these first generation individuals are calculated randomly. And generated within a user-defined parameter space. We had defined first a parameter space, a range of these parameters, and then randomly, for the first generation, the model calculates the value of the difference of the different individuals. For example, in our case, the fitness is a value that we calculate in laboratory, the density 2, but there are several parameters that we use bibliography, and in this case is when the range of the initial parameter is more large. Then we have the selection process. In the selection process, we calculate the error between the simulation results and the data of the test, using a function that the fitness function, that is an error estimator. And then we have the reproduction process in which we keep the 12.5% of the bare result of the of each generation, of the previous generation, and then we use the genetic process of crossover and mutation in order to have a variety in the individuals of the next generation. We maintain the 12.5 and the other change using this technique, the crossover and the mutation. And finally, the determination process in which a user-defined condition, for example, a solution is found that satisfies maximum error condition, a fixed number of generations, or allocated back, for example, computational time, is the condition to finish the process. the